A little while ago, I was in a Facebook group where someone was getting very frustrated with PowerPoint because she was constantly having to change PowerPoint's default shape, color, line, shading, etc. And she was having to do this on a consistent basis in PowerPoint. Well, today I'm going to go over a couple quick ways that you can change the PowerPoint default shape and the PowerPoint default text box in PowerPoint. I'm Naomi Skrzynski with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. So let's look at how easily you can change and set the formatting for the PowerPoint default shape and the PowerPoint default text box. You can start with whichever template you would like. You can go to File, New, and pick the template you would like to use for your presentation. For this training, let's pick this slice template. I'll choose the blank page layout. Now let's look at the current default format for a shape. We'll go to the drawing section and select a circle. Let's go ahead and make that circle. Well, that's a little bland. We can see no matter what shape we select, the default is this dark blue. We know we are going to consistently use a shape with a border and an inner shadow, so let's change the default. I'll click on the circle and change the shape fill to white. I'll also change the color of the outline and make it thicker. Let's add the inner shadow. Okay, that looks good. Let's go ahead and set this as the default formatting for the PowerPoint shapes. Right-click on the shape and select Set as Default Shape. Now, any shape we select will have the same formatting. We can do the same thing with changing and setting the default text box in PowerPoint. Select the text box and click anywhere on the canvas. Let's go ahead and type some text. Highlight the text and change the font, the color, and the size to your liking. Now right-click on the text box and select Set as Default Text Box. Now anytime you choose the text box, the font will be the default you chose. Now here is a major caveat. This default is only for this presentation. If you close out of it and open the template again, it will set back to the original default. So now, what you need to do is save this as a theme. Click on Design, click on the bottom drop-down arrow over here, click on Save Current Theme, and give it a name. I'll call it Test for now. Hit Return or click on Save. Now that the theme is saved, let's close out of this and open a blank new presentation. Okay, we have a blank page here. Let's click on Design. You will see there is our theme test. And if we scroll down, there is the theme for slice. We will use the theme we created, which is test. Let's right click on it and select apply to all slides and go back to home. Let's select a shape and put it on the canvas. Our default shape formatting is there. Let's look at our text box shape formatting. Yep. It's the same. Just for the heck of it, let's add a new slide for an example and choose the slice theme. Let's check the default shape and text for the slice theme. As you can see, the original default remained with that template. So you can change the default, then save as a theme and use the theme for future presentations. You might be saying, well, that's great, but I use three different formatting styles in my presentations. Here's the easy workaround on that. Click on the shape and press Ctrl+D twice to copy the shape. Move the shapes out so they are in one line, and do the same for the text box if you use different formatting for your text box. Adjust the formatting on each PowerPoint shape and text box to those three standard styles that you use. Now we'll call this your PowerPoint default shape and text box style guide. Right-click on the first PowerPoint shape and set it as the default shape formatting, assuming that is the one you use most often. Do the same with the text box. Right-click on it and set it as the default text. Add a blank slide in front of this slide. Now click on File, Save As, and Browse. Click on the Save As Type drop-down and select PowerPoint Template. Give it a file name and save. Now let's close out of this. Let's go back to File, New, select the Custom tab, click on Custom Office Template, and then click on Standard Presentation, the template that we just saved. If you select a shape, it will be the default. If you wish to change that to one of your other standard formatting styles, go to the second slide, click on the shape you want to copy, the formatting, click on the Format Painter up here, go back to the previous slide and click on the shape. You can do the same exact thing with the text box. All you need to do from this point is add new slides, always making sure the style guide is below the slide you are working on. Of course, don't forget to save your work as you go. Since you are working from a template file, when you click Ctrl plus S to save, you will need to click on Browse and save the presentation in the folder of your choosing. In the upcoming PowerPoint training sessions, I will show you how to work with master slides and templates to help you create presentations that go beyond the standard, boring, bullet-pointed PowerPoint presentations. Now, if you haven't already done so, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you will be notified. Well, we hope YouTube will notify you every time I upload a new video. I have an eclectic assortment of videos on business and life, and I'm sure you'll find something that will benefit you. And if you don't, just go ahead and message me and let me know what you're interested in, and I will create a video for you with you in mind. So until we meet again, have a wonderful day.